Ginger Harris, statistician and demographer for the National Agricultural Statistics Service. This is the third and final 2017 Census of Agriculture data highlight video. NAS's intention with this series is to offer a few remarks on census history and the data collection effort, then dive into the data with a tour through the count and distribution of farms and ranches, a look at economics, and some insights into the demographics of those involved in farm decision making, and conclude with information about additional data products that are now or will be available over the next few months. Just a brief history of the census. Conducted once every 5 years, the Census of Agriculture covers virtually every aspect of U.S. agriculture, providing a complete count of the nation's farms and ranches and the people who operate them. It looks at land use and ownership, production practices, expenditures, and other factors that affect the way farmers do business and succeed in the 21st century. The first Census of Agriculture occurred in 1840. The 2017 Census of Agriculture is the 29th in the series and the fifth census conducted by NAS after the transfer of authority from the Census Bureau in 1997. The Census of Agriculture is a very valuable public resource. The power of the census is the ability to visualize and understand important changes for key topics in agriculture at the national, state, and county levels. The data are used by producers and all those who serve American agriculture to inform decisions about farm assistance programs, technology development, farm advocacy, farm policy, agribusiness setup, rural development, and so much more. The census reports on agriculture in all 50 states and U.S. territories. It also summarizes information for other geographic areas of interest, such as congressional districts, watersheds, and zip codes. In addition to the primary report, the census also has a number of special studies, which take a deeper look at certain segments of the industry, such as aquaculture, horticulture, irrigation, and local foods. Today, NAS published the most complete data resource available on U.S. agriculture, with nearly 6.4 million distinct data points and several million more to be released in the near future. Now let's jump into one of the items that makes the Census of Agriculture unique from other NAS surveys, demographics. The Census of Agriculture is the only time that NAS collects demographic data. Let's talk a little bit about the changes that were made to the section for 2017. After each census, we work with stakeholders to capture new trends for inclusion, opportunities for streamlining, and any potential data challenges. As a result of the feedback, NAS convened a panel of experts, including producers, university researchers, and representatives of agricultural groups, to investigate ways to improve representing the involvement of all people in agricultural operations. The recommendations were accepted, and I will highlight the results of some of those today. One recommendation was a change in nomenclature. In the past, we have described farm decision makers as operators. Based on testing and advice from the panel, we learned that the term producer better reflects persons involved in farm decision making. We use the term producer throughout the 2017 Census of Agriculture. Another change, beginning in 2017, more than one person may designate themselves as a principal producer. To be able to compare back to prior census results, we selected the principal producer making the most decisions for the farm to be represented as the single primary producer. The average age of farmers and ranchers is an item that generates a lot of interest. The census shows an aging producer population, with the average age increasing by about 1 year per census cycle. The average age of primary producers increased from 58.3 in 2012 to 59.4 in 2017, continuing that trend. Average age varies across the United States. Producers in the Southeast and Southwest tend to be older than the overall average. The 2017 Census of Agriculture is introducing a new set of tables featuring farm and producer characteristics for young producers. A young producer is anyone 35 or younger as of December 31, 2017. The map of young producers looks somewhat like the inverse of the map for average age. The share of young producers is higher in the northern United States. Overall, 9.4% of producers are young. A young producer may be running his or her own farm, or they may be operating a farm with other producers who are older. 11.8% of all farms include a young producer. Note that we are now talking counts and proportions of the 3.34 million producers. This is the count of all producers for whom we tabulated detailed demographic data in the census. 321,000 of those producers are 35 or younger as of the end of 2017. Farms with a young producer participating in decisions for the farm tend to be larger than average in terms of both acres and sales. Often, these are farms that are sizable enough to support multiple family generations. The 2017 Census of Agriculture also shows farm and producer characteristics for new and beginning producers. A new or beginning producer is anyone who has operated a farm for 10 years or less, including the census year. Overall, 27% of producers are new or beginning. 29% of all farms have a new or beginning producer. As you can tell from the numbers, not all new or beginning producers are young. In fact, the average age of a new or beginning producer is 46.3. Note, however, this average is much lower than the average age of all producers. Farms with a new or beginning producer participating in decisions for the farm are smaller than average in terms of both acres and sales. Most farms are operated by producers with many years of experience. On average, producers have over 23 years of experience operating a farm. As we talked about earlier, changes were made to the demographic questions on the census questionnaire. In order to enhance collection of data from all persons involved in making decisions for the farm or ranch. The new questions, which identify a producer as someone involved in decisions for the farm, led to more people identifying as producers. While the number of farms was down by 3.2%, the number of producers was up by nearly 7%. The main change was that more farms reported multiple producers. In 2017, the majority of farms, 54%, reported more than one person involved in decision making. In 2012, 56% of all farms identified only one operator involved in decision making. Most of these newly identified producers are female. While the number of male producers fell by 1.7%, the number of female producers increased by nearly 27%, underscoring the effectiveness of the changes made to better represent all people involved in farm decision making. 36% of all producers are female, and 56% of all farms have at least one female decision maker. On average, farms with a female producer are smaller in terms of both acres and dollars. Similar to 2012, the map on your screen shows distinct regional differences in the tendency for farms to have a female producer. As part of the recommendations from the expert panel, the 2017 Census of Agriculture also included a series of new questions asking about the specific types of decisions farm producers make for the operation. Female producers are most heavily engaged in the day-to-day decisions, record keeping, and financial management aspects of the farm. Young producers are more likely than other age groups to make decisions regarding livestock, and on average participated in fewer decisions than older producers, though the differences were generally slight. The Census of Agriculture also collects data on the race and ethnicity of farm producers. The census uses the categories identified by the Office of Management and Budget for federal statistical agencies. Those specify that race and ethnicity are two separate questions. Producers who identify as Hispanic can be of any race. Producers may also select multiple race categories. This is a highly requested set of data. We will be producing additional data products over the next few months that provide a deeper dive into farm characteristics by ethnicity and race. The 2017 Census of Agriculture included a new question to identify producers who have served or are serving in the U.S. Armed Forces. Overall, 11% of producers have military service. 17% of all farms have a producer who has served in the armed forces. The average age of a producer with military service is almost 68 years old. This average is much higher than the average age of all producers. Farms with a producer with military service participating in decisions for the farm are smaller than average in terms of both acres and sales. The share of farms with producers who have served in the military is highest in the Southeast. A few items to note before this part of your data tour comes to a close. In addition to the primary report, rankings, maps, and highlight publications released today, we will be rolling out additional data products in the coming weeks and months on the NAS website, www.nas.usda.gov/agcensus. These products include Dayton County profiles, congressional district rankings, profiles by race and ethnicity, and more. As you'll see on our website, the census report is provided in a variety of formats. The data can be accessed through our web-based query tool, QuickStats. However, for greatest ease of finding specific census data, especially if you're looking for trends between census years, try our new census data query tool. Later this year, we will release the data from two Census of Agriculture special studies, the Irrigation and Water Management Survey and the Census of Aquaculture. Producers will start to hear about data collections for two upcoming special studies, Organics and Horticulture, later this year as well. Currently, Census of Agriculture data collection is being conducted in Puerto Rico, the U.S. Virgin Islands, Guam, American Samoa, and the Commonwealth of the Northern Mariana Islands. These data will be published early next year. We are already preparing for the 2022 Census of Agriculture, so NAS is soliciting input again on content. To provide your suggestions, visit our Census webpage and click Ag Census Solicitation for Input in the left-hand menu. If you're a new farmer or rancher who was not included in this 2017 Census of Agriculture, now is the time to sign up to be counted in future NAS surveys and censuses. To do so, go to the NAS homepage and click the Be Counted button at the bottom of the page. And as always, follow us on Twitter at USDA_NAS for announcements about surveys, data releases, and live stat chat opportunities. This is the third and last video. If you haven't had a chance to watch the first two videos that focused on farms and land and farms and farm economics, we encourage you to do so. Thank you for watching the Census of Agriculture Data Highlight Series.